On the other hand, I think that clash of civilizations, cultural struggles, is precisely the form of politics in Fukuyamaist global capitalist world. The only when politics is over, when we think we have the formula, the only struggles that remain are cultural struggles. And I think it's important that we break out of it. Again, how? By... the problem with term creativity, to say creative thinking, of course we need it, is that this notion creativity is so misused by people like Bill Gates, who even uses the term of creative capitalism. No? But okay, let me just finish this first part, and then I will give you some concrete proposals with provoking you. Another joke, I cannot resist to get off my skin. In what sense, along the lines I developed here, I still consider myself a Leninist. A Leninist in the sense, of course, is East Europe political jokes. I don't know if you are coming from post-communist countries. If it was also in your country, in my country, in Russia, they told me there was this classical joke about, you know, how in all many, okay, at least classes, there was this famous rooms. There was this motto by Lenin's advice to pupils, what to do: learn, learn, and learn. Lenin, no? So the joke is that they asked Marx, Engels, and Lenin, what do you prefer to have, wife or mistress? Marx, more conservative, says wife. Engels, more dissolute, says mistress. Lenin says both. And they are shocked. Lenin was supposed to be ascetic. Why? Lenin then answers, so that you can tell your wife that you are with your mistress, and you tell your mistress that you are with your wife. Then they ask him, okay, but what you really do? Lenin answers, learn, learn, learn. I think this is what, if wife stands for standard, business, career, whatever, if mistress stands for critical activity, move things, maybe we should step back in this sense and say, learn, learn, and learn. We need this. So I even tempted to say that the thesis 11 of Marx, to be reinvented today, for today, you know that famous philosophers have only interpreted the world, the time is to change it, is maybe we should turn it around, meet the time. Maybe we should say, in the 20th century, we tried to change too much the world, the time has come to interpret it a little bit more. No, I emphasize this. That's why forums like this are important. It's time to think today. Things are happening. Which things? Finally, okay, enough of these introductory jokes. Let's do something. Let me nonetheless start with this financial meltdown, which is the talk of the town, as it were. Now, you know, the first thing that did strike me, I wonder if you noticed it, was how, when President Bush reacted to the crisis, how many commentators noticed this, how when the crisis first broke out in the United States in the fall of 2008, how he used almost the same language as he did 8 years earlier after September 11's attacks, the language of emergency. A catastrophe is happening, it's the threat to our very way of life. We should forget about old partisan distinctions. It's an emergency state, we should all be united, and so on and so on. This is how I think one should start to analyze it. I think that what is happening today is something very precise. It's a counteract to the fall of the Berlin Wall, when on November 9th, 1989, the Berlin Wall fell. This was a kind of a sign of the end of a certain era, as they put it, old ideological projects, communism, welfare state, and so on. This was not, for me, the end of utopia, but the emergence of the greatest utopia, which is precisely the liberal utopia. The true utopia for me were the 90s, this Fukuyama utopia, which is, we may not yet be there, but we know where we are heading. We have the formula. liberal capitalist democracy and so on and so on. Because, you know, utopians are not idiots. They are not people who think people are ideal, we should trust people. Utopians, great utopians, are usually very cynical. They only claim, I have a formula. We just have to apply certain mechanism and it will work. So I claim again that 90s were the real utopia. And this utopia, as we know from Hegel and Marx, as all things, had to die twice. First, it died on September 11th, in the sense of, if there is a historical meaning of September 11th, it's the end of the political aspect of this utopia. History goes on. Liberal capitalist democracy will not impose itself as universal formula. What is going on now, I think, is that the second economic utopia is also at least threatened. In what sense do I mean this? When we are talking about different cultures and some global capitalism, I think that, I wonder if you would agree with this, and at the end, if I will have time, I will return to this. Here I see the trends for Europe, here. Well, I don't like to speak about different civilizations. It's too Huntington-like. But I nonetheless think that where are we today in this post-September 11th era? It is clear that liberal democratic capitalism will not impose itself as a universal formula. And we are entering a multicentric world, not only at the political level, where I think United States are objectively in decay, and if you are a fanatical leftist, you should burn a candle every evening for George Bush, who did all it was possible to do to ruin the international status of the United States. He succeeded. So, because why? You know, remember this old green motto, think globally, act locally. The problem with the United States is that they are doing exactly the opposite. They think locally and act globally. No, so you are then where you are. Like, you liberate Iraq, the result is now Iraq is much more fundamentalist than it was under Saddam. Similar problems. Okay, but let me go back. So, we are entering a multicentric world, not only in the political sense, that now there are 3-4 centers of power emerging. United States, Far East, China, India, this developing, Europe, Russia in between, Latin America, and so on. I think it's more. We are already entering also multicentric global capitalism. Different forms compete, and you don't have to be a liberal. I'm very critical of liberalism, but nonetheless, you have to admit something about liberalism and see precisely that feature, which is a positive one, threatened.